And now to Nick McCutcheon with the sports update.
While many Missouri Western students used last week's spring break for a little R&R, there was no rest for Missouri Western student athletes and athletic staff. Griffon spring sports are in full swing with baseball and softball and men's and women's golf all in action last week. Meanwhile, athletic staff were busy making preparations for this week's Division II Women's Elite Eight tournament at Civic Arena. It was a week of firsts for the Griffon baseball team, the first game ever played on campus in the program's 40-year history, the first game ever played at the Spring Sports Complex, the first run, the first home run, and the first win in a weekend series against number three Central Missouri. In the second game of the day, the Mules used an 11-run third inning to jump out to a 15-2 lead. The Griffins tried to come back, though, scoring six in both the sixth and seventh innings, but it was too little too late as Western fell 15-14. Mother Nature played havoc in the season finale on Saturday with 40-minute lightning delays in both the seventh and eighth innings, again first for the Spring Sports Complex. Down 9-3 with two out and the bases loaded in the seventh before the first bolt of lightning struck, there was a 40-minute delay. Isaac Rome up to bat, bottom of the eighth, two out, couldn't get him, struck out. Western loses 9-3, finished the series 1-3 against the number three Mules. Western finished the series with an overall record of 7-10 and they're 6-6 in MIAA play. Western will return to the Spring Sports Complex on April 1st, 2nd, and 3rd for a three-game series with rival Northwest Missouri. Western softball continued its hot start, going 4-1 at the MIAA crossover event in Springfield, Missouri. Late-inning heroics helped the Griffins earn two wins with a two-out, two-run shot in the bottom of the sixth from Carrie Lorbert to beat Lincoln 3-1, and a walk-off homer from Brittany Douglas helped move the Griffins past the Mules 3-1. Stellar pitching performances from both Janelle Belger and Jackie Bishop helped the Griffins sweep the final day, beating Missouri Southern 2-1 and Pittsburgh State 6-0. Western improved to 20-5 on the season and finished the weekend ranked 22nd in the nation. Softball will make its return to campus April 4th against Southwest Baptist. Missouri Western men's golf season got underway at the Springfield Pasta Invite in Springfield, Missouri. Shane Feist lost in a playoff for first place, but the Griffins finished 9th overall. Meanwhile, the Western women team in Pottsboro, Texas at the Pepsi Lion Invitational, Natalie Bird finished in a tie for 23rd, shooting a 171, and the Griffins finished in 9th overall. The women will host the MWSU Invitational here in St. Joseph at the Fairfield Golf Course, March 27th and 28th. The Western tennis team had last week off but has a busy week ahead. The Griffins will travel to Kirksville on Tuesday to face Truman, are back home on Wednesday against Southwest Baptist, and travel to Baker University on Saturday. The Griffins currently sit at 2-3 on the season. That's sports for now. Be sure to tune in next week when Jessica Cook and I will have results from all of Western sports this week, as well as a recap from the Division II Women's Elite Eight held in St. Joseph this week.
And now, Sarah, we're going to take a look at an investigative report by Clay Raines. It's about a political grassroots organization that started in the Midwest.
Okay, great. Let's take a look.
Following an unsuccessful bid for the presidency in 2008, Congressman Ron Paul of Texas and his supporters decided to continue the fight by turning their efforts from a campaign for the presidency to a campaign for liberty. Campaign for Liberty, a nationwide grassroots political activist group, now boasts 500,000 members nationwide. Paul Hamby's been a Campaign for Liberty regional organizer for Northwest Missouri, working on issues both large and small, federal and local, such as fighting the Real ID Act and the Animal ID Act. The group's core goals are the promotion of individual liberty, constitutional government, sound money, free markets, and an anti-war, non-interventionist foreign policy. By educating the public and getting them active and involved, Hamby says the goal of his group boils down to a simple live and let live philosophy.
But the idea, you know, the basic principle of liberty is that you should be able to live your life without interruption from the government, from rules, regulations, or penalties or taxes, so long as you're not hurting someone else. And that's the simplest concept of liberty.
Larry Flinchpaugh is a Western alum from the class of 1960. After working a number of positions, which included a career as an accountant for Phillips Petroleum, he retired and moved back to St. Joseph, where he became active in the group. Flinchpaugh says Campaign for Liberty is a nonpartisan group because they blame both parties for the nation's economic crises, foreign policy crisis, and the ballooning national debt.
If you're a Democrat and you're blaming the Republicans, or if you're a Republican and blaming the Democrats, you haven't arrived yet. You're still in Never Never Land because they're both at fault.
So we are not loyal to either party, and we know that they're both going to misbehave, and when they do, we're going to point out what they do and call them out and try to create political pain for them for misbehaving.
Though they say their group has had incredible success at the local and state levels, Flinchpaugh and Hamby say local activity has actually been limited to a relatively small number of members, something Flinchpaugh says they'd like to change.
And there's two kinds of membership. You can be a paid member where you can vote, or you can be a not paid member and you get their emails and notices of meetings they're going to have, where Ron Paul's going to speak, that type of thing. But as a group, we can make a difference because the politicians will start listening to us.
Flinchpaugh urges anyone interested to contact him at 816-676-2565 or call Paul Hamby at 816-632-0602.
We're here with LIndsey Roberts today, and we're discussing her video.
LIndsey produced a video for one of her classes. Thank you for coming today, LIndsey. Will you just tell us a little bit about your video?
I did the video for my COM 270 class, and the assignment was to do a 3-minute video with a song of our choice, and I decided to go with Harvey Danger's Flagpole Sitter.
Okay, great. And here's LIndsey's video.